AS. AS is anterior end of the pelvis. And PI is posterior end. AS is anterior end. I will use the term AS and PI for further. Now, I will use the term AS and PI. AS means anterior end. PI means posterior end of head. When the pelvis is tilted posteriorly. This is anterior, this is posterior. This is anterior, this is posterior. When it is rotated anteriorly, I will use the AS. When it is tilted posteriorly, I will use the PI. So AS and PI. Okay? I will use the term AS and PI. Now, how to check whether we have a AS or PI? Okay? We will ask the patient to lie on. आप सारे देख लो पहले फिर मैं वेलकम टू इंटर पेशेंट शुड बी लाइन फॉर इन न्यूट्रल पोजिशन विल बेंड द नीज फेयरिंग द पेल्विस एंड फ्रॉम हियर वी विल कीप अवर फिंगर्स मिडल फिंगर ओवर द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द पेल्विस और बोथ द लेग्स इन दिस केस the both the pelvis are nearly equal. So he doesn't have any AS or PI. In this case, we can change the model. Again, we explain. We ask the patient to lie on the wrong line. It should be a neutral position. We'll let the knees take care of the pelvis. And we will keep our hands on the lower aspect of the pelvis, middle finger. I'll see from there that this leg is slightly lower than this, the left leg. This is called PI. But you understand this thing, I'll again explain. I'll come to each and every man, we can make a group of 10 also. And I'll explain again. Or you can, and then you can come here and see. And this is what I think. This is how it is. Below right is L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. Okay? So, it decreases at the level of L4, L5. And just below that is it is L5. What we do is we keep our hand MCP joint over the L5. Middle finger MCP joint over the L5. Like this. If it is hyperextended, the MCP joint of the MCP is hyperextended, it is hyperrotation. It is, if it is back, it is counter rotation of the segment. Understood? Some people you must have seen too much of hypertension. It is hypertension. Many females you will see with too much of hypertension, that is hyperrotation. And if it is flat, it is counter rotation. Understood? How to check it? We keep the pentagonal over the L5 vertebra of the middle finger. If it is hypertension, it is hypertension. If it is flat, it is compensation. Has everybody understood this? Basically, it normal is like if it is too much, we call it hypertension. If it is in the middle range, it is normal. Right within compensation. Okay? Now, so you use hypertension, compensation. Then if you feel resistance, we go by 5%, then again we put pressure and release. If you feel resistance, we go back and then we put pressure. Like this we can do in all directions. Are you feeling the pressure? So we have to put enough pressure that we are not going taking the muscle. In this case, that is the patient and the muscle. We should put so much pressure that we are not going to cut the fascia, and it should not be too light to cut the skin off. Okay? If you feel resistance, we will go back slightly. Then again go back. Again go back slightly, then again go back. Again go back. So we can do it in all the directions. Okay? This is fascia release. Now comes the we call the sacral release method. This is very effective. In this, the patient is asked to bend the knees. You put the hand, lift up. Put hand over the pelvis. Put hand over the sacrum, sorry. Come down. Stay with your knees. Knees down. Put pressure on the abdomen and just pull the sacrum towards in this direction, one direction. Hold and release. Hold, feel your abs. You will get so many patients with tight sacrum, tight structures. Just you have to hold the sacrum, he will be feeling it. Hold and release. Feel your abs? Yeah, feel your abs. In those cases, with a dispersal, you can start the spinal cord mobility exercises. This is one of the best exercises you can aid the patient. It's very safe and it will work in years. Okay. First of all, get a table. Come back. Again, do it. This is concentrated action of which muscle? Transverse abdominal. And eccentric contraction when it comes down of the mandibles. Okay? Concentric contraction of the transverse abdominal and eccentric contraction of the mandibles. This is very safe exercise. You can start from day one. And for the spinal cord mobility, you can just go back, come up, go back. Back. It can be used for number of canal stenosis, spinal cord mobility. Yes, a practice girl.
Thank you.
This is the anterior cortical, next is the flexor wall. So we are getting the flexibility as well as depth. Okay? This is all the current that they have emitted. Knee is straight driving.
Usually the medial line, the patient coming to pain on the lateral side, we give left.